Hey everybody, how are you? How's everything going? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I'm out here in the RV. I'm actually in Tucson, Arizona. It's a Friday. Tomorrow we've got a fantastic seminar happening right here in Tucson. After that, I head off to San Diego and then Denver after that. But I might do a little bit of a side trip in between, and I'll let people know, or you'll find out if you don't know who I am. Again, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I say that because a lot of people share a lot of my Facebook Lives. You actually just hit the share button and you can just share it. So what I wanted to talk to everybody about is, hey, Mary, how are you? What I want to talk to everybody about is, I see all the time, and we teach this at our seminars, is a lot of folks are using obedience to stop an unwanted behavior. And let me give you a really, really good example. For instance, jumping. Jumping is a major thing. Dogs jumping on people actually takes about 3 seconds to stop. We do it all the time. I demonstrated all my seminars. You know, we do it all the, you know, all of our board and train dogs, all of our one-on-one dogs, they learn how to stop jumping pretty quick. So say all of a sudden your dog jumps on you, and then, hey, Brittany, how are you? Love you. Say your dog jumps on you, and then you say, sit, which is very, 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 you know, common for people to do. So the dog sits and then you reward it, which makes sense. The dog sat. Unfortunately, what you're doing, if you, you know, just dissect this, is you're training the dog jump, sit, reward. Jump, sit, reward. Because when a dog does sit, we absolutely reward it. When the dog does any obedience command or a behavior that we like, we reward it. But think about what you're doing. You're actually, hey Pat, how are you? You're actually doing jump, sit, reward. And obviously, if you're doing clicker training, which we do, if you're doing food training, which we do, you would click and deliver your food reward at the moment the dog sat. So then the dog is going to think, oh, how do I get this food reward? You know, jump, sit, food. Let me tell you a story. So I don't want people to do that. Let me tell you a story. Imagine this. I come home from work, and Angelo is in the kitchen with a Sharpie marker, and he's writing all over the walls, right? He's writing all over the walls. And he, of course, he's writing like, I love my papa. Like, he's a smart kid, so he's like, I love. He makes a little heart thing. He doesn't know how to spell love yet, but he makes a little heart thing. So, I love my papa. Sometimes he spells, you know, my a little bit different. I'm actually confused on how to spell my. There's so many different ways. So I say, Angelo, I said, do me a favor. Why don't you come outside and help me bring in the groceries? So then Angelo comes outside. He puts down the marker, right? He comes outside and he helps me bring in the groceries. And I'm like, good job, buddy. Thank you very much. You know, I really like it when you help me. But did I get Angelo to stop writing on the wall? Yep, absolutely. He put down the marker, he stopped writing on the wall, and he came and he helped me, and I told him what a great job he was doing. So that's not quite obedience, but that's a redirection. Same thing, don't use a redirection as well. Did he learn that writing on the wall is bad? No, not at all. Tomorrow when I come home, he'll probably like keep writing on the wall, or any other time, he'll never learn that writing on the wall is wrong. Now, don't go down the freaking nonsense down below with your typing. Oh, would you bonk your kid or would you use a shock collar on your kid? Of course I wouldn't. That's such a ridiculous comment from when people say that. But there absolutely has to be a consequence. There has to be a consequence. You know, the way we punish our children and the way we talk to our children about doing something wrong is way different than the way we talk to our dogs about it. We don't explain things to our dogs. They don't understand that. But I'm staying so hydrated this trip. It's incredible. So ever since, from Texas west, I've been hydrating so much. The problem is when I drive, I'm driving anywhere from 500 to 600 miles a day. I got to stop all the time to go to the bathroom. That's the downfall of this stuff. But boy, am I, you know, but boy, am I definitely doing a good job staying hydrated. So what I don't want people to do is use obedience. Here's another great example. A dog is fence fighting. If you don't know what fence fighting is, it's a dog that races back and forth on the fence, bark, 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 bark. And then the owners will say, here or come. So both of those things are the recall command. Recall means have your dog come to you. So your dog is fence fighting, and all of a sudden you say, call your dog to you, which is really hard to do a lot when your dog is actually fence fighting. They usually, like, their ears are off. So, but let's say the dog did respond to you. And then you reward it, as you should always reward your dog for coming to you. Absolutely, no matter what. But then, what are you doing? The dog goes, oh, I can still fence fight. I'm still allowed to fence fight. So you didn't, unfortunately, teach, boy, you got yourself a good recall. If you can pull your dog off of fence fighting for a recall, you got yourself a good recall on a dog. Kudos to you. But you didn't stop the dog from fence fighting. Same with, you know, any other bad behavior. This happens all the time. So jumping up on people or growling at food. The dog growls and you say, sit. And then you take away the food bowl. Again, you're using it. So how do you stop an unwanted behavior? The way you stop an unwanted behavior is through punishment. Punishment is not abuse. Punishment is a word that means that sucks. It's uncomfortable to the dog. It has to be intolerable. And don't do it again. That's what it is. It's not abuse. Abuse is a way different things. And if you've never, Jill, all of my social media you can share. All of it. That's why it's Jill. Come on, Jill. Come on now. That's why it's called social. I love you, Jill. I miss you. Jill, when I'm back in Rhode Island, let's connect for lunch, okay? When I'm back in Rhode Island, let's connect for lunch. So that's what it's important that people do. So now, how do you punish? Now that's the big thing. People don't know. It's not yelling. It's not screaming at the dog. So I think it's really, really important that folks understand how to not use obedience to fix behavior problems. Hey, Elizabeth, love you. There has to be a immediate consequence in order to stop that. And then what do? Obviously, you want to train your dog to be obedient. You want your dog to know at least all the basic commands with no distractions, and then teach the dog how to do commands with distractions. But be very, very careful about using obedience to stop an unwanted behavior, such as jumping, whining, growling, pulling on a leash. That happens all the time. A dog is pulling on the leash, and what do? We stop, we tell the dog to sit, and we give it a reward. It's the same thing. So the dog's going, huh, let me think. If I just sit or do what my owner says, I can start getting food rewards. We use food, don't get me wrong. We clicker train, we use food whenever we want a dog to do something. So just be careful about going down that road. That's all. That's what I want to talk to you about now, is not to do it. So what do? You do proper punishment. What's proper punishment? It's the word, using the word no. That's my punisher word. I can use the word nine. So any word that means don't do that again. But it's followed up with a consequence. What is that consequence? It could be a very firm leash correction. It could be a bonker. A bonker is a towel. It could be a remote collar. It could be something to the dog that goes, whoa, that really sucked. I don't want that to happen again. So that's how you stop the behavior. And then once you start doing this, it's now the dog has got big clarity. What's really, sorry guys, it's like really dry out here. Now the dog has got really good clarity. I always want really good clarity between yes and no. I don't want there anything in the middle. No shades of gray. Not the best book. Did you know that the first 4 days that Shades of Grey was out, they sold 1 million copies in 4 days. And that was self-published too. It's a self-published book. Anyway, so that's what I want to make sure, is that you've got really, really, really good distinction between yes and no. Okay, that's what I got. If you missed any of this, go back to the very beginning and watch it again. For all the people that are watching live, thank you so much. For all the people that are watching the replay, thank you for taking the time. And for everybody that's going to share this, you hit the button right down there and you share it. And I really, really appreciate that. All right. So that's what I got. I'll answer the questions through, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to answer some of the questions on Periscope. Travis, punish a dog, you should just give the dog love for jumping. Hopefully you're being sarcastic, Travis. Come on now. Come on. We should know better than that. Jumping dogs end up dead in shelters. A lot of people turn dogs into shelters. So I love all of you. You're all extremely special to me. Thank you all so much for watching. And that's it. Ooh, I got a special. I'm in the RV tonight. Special dinner. You ready for this? Caviar. I'm having caviar tonight in the RV. Brie cheese, caviar, all kinds of little hors d'oeuvres. I'm going to eat well. What I'll do is I'll document that. I'll do an Instagram stories. I'll do Instagram stories on my dinner tonight. If you're not following me on Instagram stories, follow. It's a lot of fun. What's an appropriate punishment for puppies who jump? You can use a little bit of a bonker. Yep, you can use a little bit of a bonker. Remember, be careful. Remember, you're not raising puppies, you're raising dogs. You're not raising puppies, you're raising dogs. Show the dogs. My dogs are in place right now. They're not sleeping, but they're resting. They just ate dinner. Ooh, I got some good bones for them. I went to a natural pet food store, and I stocked up on some good marrow bones. You want to see my dogs? Well, pay attention to my social media feed. I show my dogs all the time. All right, go to my Instagram stories. My dogs are there playing fetch. Do that right now. Instagram stories only last for 24 hours, so check out my Instagram stories. I show my dogs all the time. But this is me, my little talking head, right? I'm in Tucson, Arizona. I'm at my next location for my next seminar. So, a lot of fun. A lot of good stuff happening here. Thank you for all the hearts. Thank you for all the likes. Remember, anybody does any nonsense down below, I gotta get rid of it. You know, that's not what this page is. This page is not for, you know, any hate or nonsense or anything like that. So, wish you were closer. Corinne, I travel the world. Where are you? I might be there next week. Trick treating up the trick. Oh, South Corinne, go back. I'm coming back on March 3rd. I'm coming back on March 3rd. So go buy a ticket, because the first one, working spots sold out. All right. The outside dog, Mac, he comes in at night now. He has a doghouse that's heated, but it's been a little bit cold. Plans for Alaska. I would love to do a seminar in Alaska. Find me a location and I'm there. Find me a location and I'm there. Janice. Oh, Jody, thanks. I love you too. Arizona is stunning. Tucson was beautiful. So the trick training video, it's 98% done. It's a trick training live streaming. It's 98% done. It is our wonderful trainer, Brittany. I've got three awesome trainers at the training center. John, Brittany, and Jordan. Awesome, awesome trainers. Brittany did all of the trick training video, and it's going to be half price until Black Friday. We're launching it possibly this weekend or maybe Monday. Tony and I, there was a couple of little things. Specifics requirements, at least a couple thousand square feet. I want to be able to fit about 30 to 40 people in there. Janice. I know, Tammy, I'm going to pin it to the top of our Facebook page. And then I'm also going to do an Instagram story on it. I'm going to do a Facebook Live on it. And I'm going to do a Periscope on it. All right? I know. Trust me. We want to get it right. But it's going to be half price just for a week. Yeah, we're right there. We're right there. I almost sound like my buddy Sean O'Shea from The Good Dog Now. We're right there. We're this close. The trick training is online. It'll be on the website. You go to the website, cooldogtricks.com. Cooldogtricks.com. Nope, it's on a separate platform. So it'll be but it'll be on our Facebook page. There'll be a link there. All right. Okay, madly in love with all of you. Time for me to go. I'm so honored that you in half price board and train. I'm in. We would never do that. No. Nope. We don't discount our board and trains ever. Never. So, all right. Take care. Love y'all. Bye bye.